Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Now series. Today I would like to tell you a little bit about the software download. Where can you find the Shuko software, and not only for Shukal and Shukal Next, but also for the machinery, the CAM updates, and the profile setups and everything. First of all, you see on my screen, you have the Shukal app on the right side, and you often get this message that the Shukal is outdated or something. The most important thing is that you have the latest service pack in the version you're working on. So don't get afraid by this, just get in contact with your administrator in the company so that you make the same updates in the same time, so you have all the correct software. And also, if you click on this one right here, you can see which program version you have of Shukal and also which service pack. And as you already know, you need the same service pack on every computer running, also if you have like a network installation and so on. Therefore, I recommend you that you do the installation a specific time that everyone is informed about this, so they can plan for it. Where do we find our software for Shukal? As you know, we have the software download available on our webpage under My Workplace. So if we log into the Shuko web, you will see here. And to get access to the download section, you need to log in. So first I go to log in, say okay. And then I go to My Workplace. Go to software, and here find everything you need. So if you scroll down, you see here, we go to calculate, and here we can find Shukal software download. And also for the CAD software, you find it here. But for now, I would like to have the latest Shukal software. So I click on this one, and here you can see, you can choose between a 32 and 64-bit version. Normally you choose the 64-bit version because it can allocate much more memory, which makes it a lot easier to work with. And then you can download the installation instructions, or you can go directly to the download area. And as you see here on the left bottom, click here and can say open. And then you can choose here which version you want to download for Shukal. And in this case, I would choose the latest version 2020. Also, besides the Shukal and Shukal Next software, you also need the CAM updates for the machinery. And this program is called the GDF, the General Download Finder. And it's also located in the installation file of Shukal. So when you download Shukal, you will also get this folder, Extras. And if you click here, you will see there is a folder called GDF. Here you can find the setup file and also get some information in English and German. And if we open up the GDF, you have two settings. There are one's the program and also the settings. So I start by clicking on the settings. And here you can decide exactly which machinery do you have and what do you want to download. For example, you could also download all the service pack, the article data updates, and for example, we can do this directly over Shukal, or we can do this over the general download finder. This makes sense if you have one administrator in the company who does this, then maybe that person gets a little bit more control. There's a new update. Okay, I will install this on my colleagues' computers and so on. So this makes sense. But you have to choose if it's the 64 or 32-bit version. If I click next, you will see all the CNC machine. So here you just type which type of CNC machine you have. For example, if I have the AF310, I would click here and say next. And then there are also some other machinery like the cutting machines and double miter saws and so on. So you just mark which machine you have available, and then you will also get the proper updates for it. I say save, and then if I go back and start the application, the general download finder, like this. The program will automatically start looking for if there are any the latest software for the information you have been looking for. For example, in my case, it was the 3.10, and then it will be downloaded. And also, you can enter which folder it should be downloaded to, and you get this information automatically. And this is how it's done. It's pretty easy, but I would recommend one person doing this, because otherwise you don't you lose kind of the control of who is doing the updates and do we have all the same version and so on. So this is up to the administrator. And then in Shukal, I say cancel now because I already downloaded this. If I go into Shukal, if you logged in as an administrator, you have the possibility to go into general settings and then the update settings. And here you can actually say administration, okay. And then you can set for each and every computer which one has the possibility to see if there's a new service pack update, a new article data update, for example. And this helps, because if you turn this off for the colleagues, they then won't have these pop-up messages on the screen saying there's a new service pack, there's a new update. It's better that only one person have this, and then it's easier to plan when to install everything. So I would recommend to take this checkbox away for those two and only leave it for the administrator. This makes life much easier. Then say apply, okay. So this is a little bit things you need to know about the updates. Like, you have it on my workplace, the Shukal Next updates, and also the general download finder, and also turn off the automatic updates on the screen. This was the information for today. Thank you, and thank you for listening. Bye-bye.